this one. This is bidirectional port RAM, because somebody asked, this is also important also, about this in-out. This we will discuss first. This zoom in update. Is this visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, guys, there, if to someone is not visible, kindly unmute and talk to me. Don't type anything in the chat window, because I have to come here at this place and have to go to this chat and see who has typed what. So, for that reason, you just unmute and tell that it's not visible. So, assuming now it's seen by everyone, so let us start. So here, what we have here is, we are trying to understand basically, before even going to that one, let us say we have something, this sort of, this black box is there with us. So we have this black box. This black box has got some primary inputs, some primary outputs. So these are called, as you know, several times in the past we said, these are primary outputs and these are called primary inputs. In the past several times we discussed intermediate signals, we don't consider them as a part of primary inputs, and intermediate output signals inside this box, we don't consider them as a part of primary outputs. So this knowledge is required before we translate hardware behavior to RTL. What is primary input? What is primary output? This knowledge is required before you translate this hardware behavior into RTL. This RTL, everyone must be knowing what RTL means, register transfer level. Again, what is register transfer level means, everyone must know answer by this time. That, it is synthesizable. Everyone must know what is synthesizable means. So like that, everything is interlinked. So it produces a netlist. Everyone must know what is netlist means. So that's what our learning journey is. So you should not say, I don't remember this. So anyway, back to here the point. So in this regard, what we most, sometimes what we may have, some codes like in-out codes. This is, you see clearly it's input port. The direction is shown like that. And you see clearly it is output port. The direction is seen like that. In some cases, the direction is like that. Say IO port, input and output port. It is acting like a IO port. So in a Verilog HDL, as we know that port supported by that input port keyword is there. In that, there is a keyword called output and there is a keyword called in out. In out. So we have this one. One keyword is, first keyword is input. The second keyword is output. We know with these two keywords, if there is a design description, that is, you have modeled, everyone must know what is modeled or modeling means, because several times in the past we discussed. So if you have modeled, then everyone knows how to develop a test bench for that. So, but what if this comes here? If in-out comes, then how to treat the in-out in the test bench? That is the today's discussion. How do you treat that signal in-out? So for that, guys, basic understanding is that several times we have said in the past, in previous videos, you can see, these are actually, they belong to net data type. In the past, we have recorded videos on YouTube also available. net data, right? They belong to net data. We said in the past lectures. In net data type, implicitly they belong to Y. Implicitly they belong to Y. Implicitly means you don't need to mention in the while you write a code here, module, and when you use a keyword called input, there is an input identifier A comma B, for example. You don't really need to write wire. You don't really need to write wire A comma B. This you don't need to write. If you are writing like this, is there any harm? Means there is no harm. But compiler is going to anyway treat. Compiler anyway going to treat them as a wire only. So that's why this is called implicitly. So what is that? Implicitly, your compiler. Array that somebody needs to. So you have this one issue. Implicitly means this one. Compiler, what it does, compiler automatically treats such scalar type. Remember, that is applicable only for scalar, especially new learning there. Remember, that is only applicable for scalar type identifiers such as this. They are scalar type, meaning 1 bit. For them only this rule is applicable. You really don't need to write explicitly like this. Compiler is going to treat them implicitly. Though you are not mentioning, it is going to treat. That is called implicitly. Implicitly, compiler is going to treat all scalar identifiers as wire only. So in such case, if this is the case, where we are about this setup, input, output, in-out. So these are actually in the past what we have seen, we have discussed that they belong to net data type. Meaning what? Even this belongs to net data type. In-out also belongs to net data type. So in-out also belongs to net data type. So in such case, shall I have to treat this in-out here in the test bench as a wire or reg? That question comes to mind. So for that answer is, we have to treat as a wire. If we treat as a wire, then how do we handle this description? With an example, we will demonstrate. That example is this. Everybody able to see this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us understand, this is a bidirectional portal. We have a clock input, we have write enable, and we have one address. This is 8-bit address and data, 8-bit data. So if block diagram level, if you see this one here, this one, let me take here. So here, this one, something like this. What it is having? Clock, ELK, that is input. This one is the input. Now what is there? This is write or read enable. Write or read enable, this one, this signal. The other signal is address we have. A, B, D. This address is 8 bit. And we have data. This data is again 8 bit. But if you see this data here, in this case, it is in out, meaning here this is bidirectional. Now, such a behavior is there, where in the code, how do we represent this one? Because this data here is, you have here sort of, this is, you can represent here, this is also data, because it's out also. And the same is here, that is in also. So that's the behavior now we have, that's the behavior that we have. In fact, here, first of all, to the new learner, there what I'm trying to present here. Is that clear? This behavior, is that clear? Yes? Answer, no answer?
Yes, sir.
So everybody speak, unmute and speak and then mute. Unmute and respond and mute. So now understand this code, what is happening here. When posit clock works, otherwise you see the assigned state. When this signal is low, meaning zero. Zero means this negation, you are negating, meaning you are making it as a one. One if you make, that is true. True means data out. Data out is available on this data line. What is data line here for you? It's a in-out pin it is. So when this is a zero means read, you are reading. Zero means read. When zero, that is when you want to read, read enable is made, then this data out is made available on this data out. What is data out? If you see this data out here, if you see this data out, now we have here, this data out we have here. Let us come to that data out. When there is a posit clock begin, if write enable, this is if one, this is one. This meaning is what? What is the meaning of this and what is the meaning of this? If this is zero, if this write enable could be one or could be zero, right? So in our case, if it happens to be zero, meaning we are negating here, in that case it is becoming the true. And then this statement is applied to this data. Otherwise, it is held at high impedance state. Meaning, this data, there will not be anything. It is held at high impedance state. Now, you come here, this negation, this logical negation, this one. You don't have a logical negation here. Meaning what, it could be again zero or it could be one again, because it's externally controlled by you. So let us think for a while it is one. For a while, let us think it is a one. Meaning, right, we are assuming when one write, when zero read. So meaning now it could be zero or it could be one. We are analyzing, assuming it as a one. So if it is one, meaning this data you are writing to the memory location. Where is the memory location? Here is the memory location. This one. This one is a memory location. How many locations are available here? Zero, that is mem of zero, one. Another is mem of one, that is another. Mem of two, that is another. So this one is like that, it is written, it's an array. Say array. Then each array location is of size 8 bit, meaning this mem of 2 is 8 bit, mem of 1 is 8 bit, mem of 0 is of 8 bit. So meaning how many locations are there? Basically 3 locations. In this example, we just to demonstrate this in out, we have taken 3 memory locations. Now what is that we are doing here? When write is enabled, then data that is there on the port, this port is working like an input port. The data that is available on the data line that is written into the memory location, this memory location. Is that clear? This portion, is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what we are
doing, yes, sir.
This is a, this could be a zero, this could be one. So we started assuming it as a one. Now let us say if it is 0, if it is not 1, then what? If it is not 1, meaning it is 0. 0 means it is false. If false, then this will not be treated by the if statement. It comes to else. So meaning what? Else means this portion will get. So whatever in this memory location it is there, that is put on data underscore out this one. Data underscore out, this is handling that contains of this location. Where we are putting this data underscore out, here we are putting the data underscore out. When we put this data underscore out, since when we have come here, when this is zero, we have come, right? Zero means this is zero, no? This is zero means what? We have only one signal. Only one signal for read write. Let us say first this is one, then that is write into the memory. If that is zero, then read from the memory. That's our understanding. So we have demonstrated this one now. Demonstrated means explain. When this is a one, this data that is there on this port, like this data working like a input port. In that case, when this is a 1, because we're writing into the memory location, this memory location. Now, the other case is what? It is 0. It is 0 means what? This particular memory location, whatever the contents are there, that contents will put on data underscore out, this one. This very one, that very container, this very container is a still W0. W0 means negation of W0, meaning this is 1, this is true, meaning this is let on data. So reading. So this data in that case working like an output port. So this in-out is such a port. In a case it works like this one input port. This is here, it is working like the input port. Here it is working here in this case input port, and whereas here it is working like a output port. Here in this case it is working like a output port. So how you are handling output port, this is how you are handling. You are using a intermediate data handler. This is with the help of reg. This reg is neither a primary input nor a primary output. So with this coding technique also, you have to you can enhance your coding techniques also. You all the time cannot depend on the input identifiers and output identifiers alone. Wherever there is a need, where there is a requirement, sometimes you may have to create something like reg. Sometimes also we may also have to create wire arms. But in this example, reg is needed. So we have used reg. But this reg associated variable, this data underscore out, mem, this one, these are neither, they belong to our this one, the primary input nor primary output. But still they contribute here to development of this RAM. So with this example, our prime focus is this in-out. How we code this one, create this one in the test bench. If this is clear, we will move to the test bench. If this is not clear, you can unmute and so now let us go to simulation. In this simulation, yes.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, in line number 17, you are using data underscore out now, sir. Why can't we use directly data, sir?
This reg, you see the reg here declaration? This reg declaration you might be seeing here, line number 7. What is our idea? Our idea is to build a RAM, random access memory. Random access memory has got this one, right? Just a moment. Your random access memory has got some locations. Location 0, location 1, location 2, So these locations are there, one, two, like that. And every location is capable of holding some bits. In this example, this portion, if you see this portion, if you see, we have only, for demonstration purpose, we have taken only three locations. It's one and two, zero, one, two. These are the locations. This is for this one and this one. And each location is capable of holding 8 bits. Now what we are doing here with this help here, when write enable is 0, we want to read the contents here out on the output port when this write enable is 0. So we want to put this contents here. Why? Because this one is helping us here, if you go where here. This one is helping us to get the data on the output port when this WE is here. This one is helping. So these are the means to build this hardware. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
The one who asked, is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So these sometimes what I was emphasizing earlier, sometimes you solely means completely, you cannot only depend on these identifiers to build your hardware. You may also have to have sometimes such sort of declarations. You see, reg. To build this one, we have taken this reg. In fact, they are not primary input, they are not primary output. But we have to use them to build this one. So that you will understand later on, further exercises if you do, why they are required and all, you will understand. In some examples, in earlier also we demonstrated wire we used. Though that wire is not a primary input, not a primary output. Wire we used. So in this example, to build this behavior where we have three locations, 0, 1, 2, and definitely this is not a perfect, I am warning everyone there, this is not a perfect RAM code, because why it is not perfect RAM code, I will tell. If you see locations, address locations here, how many address locations are there here, total 8 bits. 8 bits means 2 power 8 possible cases. 2 power 8 means how much? I think 256, am I correct? 2 power 56, am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So meaning what?
256.
Yeah, 256. 256 address locations possible actually to address is there. But how many locations we have taken here? Only three locations, just to demonstrate this one, this purpose, this in-out purpose. Our main intention with this example, through this example, is to demonstrate in-out in the test bench how we treat. That's the main intention of this demonstration. In fact, if you see clearly, there are several shortcomings. This I will in some other class we will develop a RAM, complete RAM with a 256 locations possibly. So, but here what I am trying to focus just for a while briefing is here address locations, if you see, we have 256, but the locations that we have taken, for example, here to make you understand this in-out behavior, only three locations we are addressing. So some problems are there. This is not going to give you the perfect RAM. Is that clear to everyone? The demonstration purpose here is to in-out, how we in-out we take in the test bench. Is that clear to everyone? Intention is,
yes,
that
sir.
Whether,
yes, sir.
Whether our intention should be clear or what we are trying to learn. So now we are trying to learn here in this example. This is the perfect example to understand in out here in the test bench, how do we handle. So you have here this one, you have your some signal coming in to you, maybe data. And the same data is also out, depending upon your write this signal. The moment it is one, write means this is like this port is functioning like an input port. Anything can be written inside the memory. When this is one. But when this is zero, the data that is there, if you go to the particular address location, that data can be read out from the same port. We don't need a separate port for that, for reading, writing one port and for reading one port, for output, that is reading, for input meaning writing, for writing. So we don't need two different ports here. With one port only, we are doing a job. Such a port is a in-out port. Is supported by the Verilog history. So how do you handle in the test banking? This is the case, how do you handle? So now let us move. If you have any doubts further, you can ask, no issues with that. But just let me summarize about this very quickly. This is a basic RAM model. In this RAM, we have in fact a total 256 locations, but this to demonstrate this in-out, we have taken three locations here. And we are modeling this one. Modeling means several times I said in the past, we are describing the behavior. Describing the behavior of any chosen hardware. In this example, chosen hardware is a bidirectional port RAM is our chosen hardware. How it is functioning? When there is a clock signal, when write is high, then this data contains are written inside the this particular memory location. That's how this is this is used. This address now, if you see address, these are the address bits you are using here. This address. So how many possible address locations? 256 we can go, but we are using only three. Not 256. Among these available three only, we are writing the data contents here. This data contents are written. When data contents are written, when this is one. If this is not one, then what it would be? It would be obviously zero. Zero means what? Read. Read means what? From some memory location. From whatever the memory location that user is looking for, if he provides the address, if he or she provides the address, then that particular address contents are read out. Read out where? On a port. On a which port? This one, data underscore out. Yes, this data underscore out. When this is zero, right? This is happening. When this is zero means, it is logical negation, meaning one. One means this statement. This statement is data underscore out. Data underscore out means this contents. These contents are going where? On data itself. Data is, again, here in this case, it is behaving like an output port. In this case, it is behaving like an input port. Hopefully this is clear, this one. If you have any doubts, no problem, you ask 1,000 times, but you have to get the things clear. That is the main agenda. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So now, memory is...
Memory is?
Each of
8-bit.
Memory 0.
Each of 8-bit.
So... So won't it be 8 × 8 × 8? So that will be 512, sir. Nothing. What is that, sir?
How is it? Okay. Just come on. See, in this example here, what we have this. Let us say this address. No address. You focus on address, the one who asked, you please keep responding. This is address, no? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So this address is
yes, sir.
2^8, right? 2^8, no? Possible, because 8 bits, no? Meaning yes, what 2^8 means? 256, right?
Yes,
meaning
sir.
What 0 to 255 we can go, no?
Yes, sir.
So this is one part. This part is the address part. This part is the A
Understood,
this
sir.
part is the address part, ADD part. Now, in this address location, yes, in this address location, you can keep some amount of bits, no? In this,
yes,
address,
sir.
So I was telling that this address portion is clear to you, no? Address.
Yes, sir.
Now, in each address, we can keep some amount of data, no? Some amount of data we can keep,
yes,
no? In each address. So what is the amount of data is dictated by this one? 7:0, meaning in each location we can keep what 8-bit data.
8-bit.
Is that clear?
Okay.
8-bit data.
Yes,
one.
Sir.
So that's why here, if you see here, this portion here, data out, this data out, if you see, if mem of, let us say this is 0, mem of 0, meaning this address, suppose. So this particular 0, this particular 0th location, if you go here, this particular particular location, what is the amount of data it can store is dictated by this one. That is 8-bit we can store. So meaning what? Mem of 0, what is the amount of data it will be there on that? It will be there 8-bit. So this 8-bit is now going to this data out. Data out is capable of,
yes,
holding 8-bit. So this 8-bit we are assigning to this data. Data is capable of holding how many bits? 8 bits.
8-bit.
Is that clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So can we move to now test bench? Shall we move to the test bench?
Sir.
Okay. So let us go to the test bench.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now carefully observe everybody there. This is the test bench. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now carefully observe. In this, as usual, our usual practice is all inputs. Let me take this one. Our usual practice is all inputs here. These inputs, how we put in the test bench with a reg, is it not? In the earlier classes we learned, no, all input keywords that are there, they will be replaced. The input keywords are replaced with the reg keyword. That in the previous lectures we have taught several times. I told you several times why is reg and all. Every discussion I took, I have explained very clearly. The YouTube recorded videos are there. You can watch. And those who are attending since the beginning, I think for them it is clear. Is that clear to everyone there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now,
yes,
now
sir.
If you see this one, this is our main today's agenda. This in-out. In-out, as I said here in my paint here earlier, I was telling you people that this input keyword and output keyword and in-out keyword, by default, they belong to which data type? Net data type. We covered in the previous sessions, you have to recollect net data type. So net data type, they implicitly belongs to which data type in the net? They belong to wire. Meaning what? This is a wire, where it is here. This one is a wire actually. When it comes to here, this one, when it comes to here, it should be wire. It should be wire. It cannot be rich. That is the one point you have to note. What is the point that you have to know? Though it is having in associated with it, but we have to treat it as a out, and we have to put here where in the test bench as a wire. Point number one, that is point number one. Point number two is the size of that port also needs to be taken into consideration. You simply cannot put like that, simply data wire and data cannot. You have to put this along with this size, vector size. That is point number two. how to treat that one, that in now in a test bench as a wire. Okay, and the size also needs to be taken care. If it is a scalar, scalar. If it is vector, it is vector. Now coming to this one, port binding. You know very very well port binding. Is that clear? This portion is not required any discussion, right? Port binding.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us move here. This is important observation that is required. This is compulsory in any code, wherever you have in now. Let us. You have to put this one. Why this one? Just because this port, this statement we are putting, just because this port, in-out port. Because of in-out port, what you have to take care is, this care you have to take care. This port, that is the in-out port, how you are going to handle, let us see this one, through this example. Let me clear this one first. What I am doing here, I will come to this statement. I am not running away from this statement, why I have code. Now, observe this one. Initial begin, clock is zero. We are using forever loop. We are using forever loop. And this forever, for every 50, alternate 50, this clock is negated. This is the bitwise negation. This tilde, you see the tilde sinus, small sinusoidal, that is your tilde symbol. That is the bitwise negation. This one. Is that clear? So this portion is used to generate the clock. Now what I am doing here? This statement is over. This initial statement here, it is over. In this initial statement, if I remove all this confusing here, now I think it is very clear, neat. Is that clear, this one? In this initial, I am generating the clock. For every 50 time unit, this clock is negated. Is that clear, this portion?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. Now,
sir,
observe
what
carefully.
Happens if I don't...
What happens? I did not
don't give it. Initial as zero.
If you don't give
initial, if I don't initialize clock as zero, but
if you don't initialize clock as zero,
but
I mean you mean this one. If you don't give clock as zero, what happens to this statement? Is that your question?
Yes, sir.
If that is your question, what is the default value of the reg? Can you tell what is the default value of the reg? Default value of the reg is x. Default value of the x reg data type is a x. Is that clear? So what we are trying to do now? We are trying to negate clock. CLK equal to negation of X. So now what happens? You have to get the answer. For that, we already covered in our class, previous classes, we already have covered. What is that you have to look in that case? In that case, you have to look that table. Which table you look? Given by the compiler. So if that happens, how it is going to behave? What is that going to behave? These tables you have to remember. At that time, I was this one, you see this one? Hello?
Sir.
This one, what is stated by the compiler language standards? This we should not neglect. What is that you see bitwise negation if you take, if you negate this X, what is the result? Hello.
X.
Meaning forever it is unknown value, no? Is that
yes,
here now the one who asked? So if you put by default, this red belongs to variable data type. All variable data types, under variable data type, we have five subtypes. All these in the initial classes we have seen. By default, the value is X. So now what is that we are going to do, trying to do here according to your question? We are trying to negate here without initializing this one. We are trying to negate something. What is that then we are trying to negate if you don't initialize? We are trying to negate this X. If we are trying to negate the X, what happens, the consequence is? Hello?
Unknown.
Unknown. So meaning we cannot generate the clock. That is the conclusion. Is that clear? Hello? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have to initialize. So now since we initialized, now we know a value. So that value is 0. At 50, what happens now? This 0 will be negated and it will become 1. Next, till 50, it will be from there 50 to 50, meaning at 100. At 100, it will be 1. Again, that 100 to 50, meaning at 150, it will become again 0. So like that, for every 50 alternate, this clock is negated. With that way, this initial block is helping us to generate the clock. Now coming to this one, this portion here, we have data underscore reg. What we are going to do data, we are going to initialize this data. What is that data here? If you see this one here, we want to write something, we want to put something inside this memory. So this memory, we want to put something inside the memory location. So that something memory location, this data underscore reg we have taken. And this data underscore reg, if you see here, it is initialized. It is initialized, sorry, not initialized, initialized. It is declared. It is declared. Otherwise, without declaring here, if you use data, then it will throw error. So you have to declare first. We have declared here at line number 20, we have declared data underscore reg. Now we are using that data underscore reg. In that data underscore reg, we are putting this contents. Hexadecimal value 0, 1 we are putting inside this data underscore reg, and the size is 8 bit, because it is 8 bit, it is capable of holding 8 bits. So now that 8 bits, these are the 8 bits, hexadecimal. So first upper will be 4 zeros, lower will be this 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 3 zeros and 1. So to put together 8 moved into this one. And the address we are giving here, 0th address location, and we are telling it is a write, or WE is a 1, meaning write is high. If write is high, then obviously this is going to happen. This is going to happen, that this action will happen. How this action will happen? If you see here, this data reg, when this is 1, are you understanding why it is important now? Because this data is a in-out type. So for that, when it is 1, this is 1, this is acting like a input. So we have to manage that scenario with this assign statement in the test bench. That is a very important key point, the key takeaway of today's lecture is this. Everybody, is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this in out, I don't remember, somebody on WhatsApp also asked whether
yes,
that person is available here, you can respond. Is that clear? Somebody asked on WhatsApp. So in out, this is how you handle, because this port is in this here, it is in out type. In out type means it is also acting like input, it is also acting like an output. How we handle means, this is how we handle. When this is 1, it is actually taking the data, writing, meaning it is like an input. Let me one more time here. This is 1. What is 1? Your WE is 1. 1 means in that scenario, this is acting like an input. Input means they should take some data. This data port should take. So it is taking here in this case. Now let us go to this one. Straight, let us go to read. Let us say the address, I am giving address 00, and I am telling that hardware module read. Read how I will tell the hardware module by making WE0. So if I make WE0, what is really happening? Data read is happening. Let us see data read happening or not. If this is 0, if 0 means what? This will not be written here, no? It is held at high impedance state. High impedance state means whatever the data, previous data is there, the data will be available. Just a moment. Now, it is like this. I am, for understanding purpose, I am drawing this one here. The data now, because at output side. Now, when this is 0, this port is like this. High impedance state, meaning whatever the previous data is there, this is accessible. This is held at high state, meaning this is actually is a port which is actually input output. So when it is 0, this is high impedance state on data line, meaning this is not going to accept any input now. For that reason, it is high. It is not going to accept any input now. It is not going to take any input externally from here. It is high, meaning this part is open now. This is not closed. This is not closed. It is open now. It is open. Meaning this portion here, whatever that data is there, that is still readable, no? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
This concept, high impedance state concept, it should be clear. Several times in the past also we have seen, we have, suppose say, you have gates, so for example, tri-state gates, several times in the past we have seen. I don't know whether how many of you are new here and how many of you are from beginning they are attending. You have tri-state gates, something like that. That is inverter, but this is a buffer. So if this is a buffer, if this is 1, then whatever that here you put, that is seen here. If you put 0, that 0 is seen here. When this is 1, if you remove this one, since you removed this one, this is held at tri-state, meaning this is whatever you put 1 or 0, it will not go here. Previously, whatever there, that will be there. Previously, whatever there at the output port of this gate, that is still available. But new data, whatever you put here, it will not go, because this you remove this one, you put 0. So it is this is open now. It has become tri-stated. This has become tri-stated. Now previously whatever is there is still available. So same concept here. Is that clear, this one, this behavior? So let us very quickly simulate this one. Let us simulate very quickly. So that's how, guys, there you handle your in-out. You try a few more examples that will give you hands-on understanding. I mean, you will get a confidence. So what really, how that, how it should behave, you get a confidence. Confidence is something important. This is our, this one. Let us analyze this one. First clock. First clock. You see the value here at this portion. Clock is 1. Your write enable is 1. So at this address is 000. Now what is there on the data reg? Data reg, that is 001 we have given in the data reg. That is seen on the data line. So meaning this data is now writing here. Where it is writing to memory. Similarly, you move on here. Same thing you observe. you move on to the next clock, same thing you observe, but you move on to the fourth clock. Now you see the changes here. Your WE has become zero. Zero means what? Read means what? From which address we are telling zero? Zero address location, what we have kept here? We kept something. You remember here at this point? This is the zero address. So what we have kept? One, no? That one is available, see here. This is read zero, WE, that is zero means read. Your clock is there. Now address that we are demanding is 00. What you see data reach contains 11. But are you writing in the data this 11, or are you taking the old data which is there at the 00? What you see?
It's taking old data, sir.
Old data. So you are reading it. So that is tri-state behavior. That is the tri-state behavior. Old data is still available because of this coding. So that's how, guys, you handle your this in, out, port in test benches. This is very important, very important. We cannot neglect in, out, how we handle in the test benches. Because in a practical cases, several times, possibly we may have to face this problem. So in such case, remember, this is how we have to assign, you have to put. And as usual, you write your test bench. In the test bench, let us quickly summarize because we are running out of time also. And we have to go that slow also. I just cannot run faster, because if I run faster, it is a bit complex example. We have to understand slowly. So that's why I slowed down my explanation today. So let's go to summary. Let us summarize very quickly. Summary is this. In this, if we have in-out, then that in-out is with the wire only. It is declared in the test benches along with its size. That is the first point, key point to remember. The second key point is, we have to assign, we have to use the assign data flow level modeling keyword assign to that wire using a reg. Reg will drive this net. This is the reg. This reg data type will drive the net data type. This data belongs to net data type, because as earlier said, data is belongs to wire. Wire is actually net data type. Who is driving the net data type? Reg data type is driving the net data type. How? Here is this is your test bench stimulus. This is the test vectors. Whenever there is a read, in this example, it is read signal. In your any other example, it could be anything. So when this comes, that is read signal is high, what should happen? That we have to question. In your whatever example you take, so if some signal, let us say ABC signal, if ABC signal is high, then if your wire is acting like a input, then you have to pass your whatever that contains that you want to pass to that this one output. It behaves like an output, so you pass like that. But the moment you want to make it as an input, you tri-state it. How you tri-state? When that ABC is not true, then you tri-state. So in that case, it acts like an input. So it is acting like an output. When this is true, when it is false, it is going into the tri-state state. Because of it is going to the tri-state state, it is holding the previous data and it is becoming an input. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, guys. With this, we will wrap our session.